This is not just a date picker. It is both a date and time picker. It uses a smart code that auto-detects date and time ranges, generating and rendering each view based on what is needed. When dealing with dates only, you are in single mode. However, when dealing with date and time, you are on dual mode. The date picker is always on standby in case you want to change the date. The date selected on the date picker view will update the date you see on the time display. Now, look at this view. This entire display is embedded into the code. In fact, everything you see or you have seen, the date picker controls, setting controls, the time picker controls, everything is written in code. So, do not be alarmed when you see a blank user form in the design view of the VBA editor. In the last course in the date picker series, we'll design and add the intelligence that drives the time picker. When our date and time picker is considered final, we'll consume the entire structure using the code. It's a fascinating tutorial. You don't want to miss that one. In the meantime, you can try to examine the code and figure it out. When these courses are all published, trust me, the knowledge you will gain will make you forget how long you waited for it. I'm putting a lot of work into these courses so that you will learn with clear understanding and become a professional in no time. Listen to those who have taken part 1 and 2 of the Date Picker series. Go over some of the reviews and you will understand what I mean. Now, if you're watching this and the course you are looking for is still not yet published, please kindly bear with me. I'm a new instructor and doing this part-time. So how does the time picker work? Like the date picker, if your target cell already has a date and time, when the time picker opens, that date and time will be displayed at the top. However, if the cell is empty, the current date and time are displayed instead. If you want to make changes to the date, you can click on this button right here and then select a new date. Next, if you want to adjust the time, you can use these controls to adjust the time accordingly. And that's not all. If using these controls is not fast enough for you, don't worry. You can use a keypad instead. To do that, click on the time value you want to change and you will be able to update your time like this. Cool, isn't it? Even on this view, you can still access the date picker and change your date if you want to do so. If that also is not enough for you, you also have an option to use the keyboard. To do this, click on the value you want to change. When the keypad shows up, ignore it and use the keypad on your keyboard. Press the Enter key on your keyboard and that's it. This is a very intelligent date and time picker. It is simple to use and is designed to be user-friendly and looks familiar. Above all, I built it for teaching purposes. I designed these controls by looking at the timer on my smartphone and the volume control on my PC. The idea was to create something most people are familiar with, so that even without this guide, you can use this time picker being guided by your expectations. The Date and Time Picker is a huge program that uses a simple decoupling technique to deploy resources only when they are needed. What this means is that at one point when you are using this date picker, the time picker and all other views don't exist. Instead, they exist only in code. So the entire code in general is able to manage itself so that it remains lighter throughout. This technique makes what could have been a heavyweight program light and fast tool ever. I teach a lot about code management step by step throughout the Date Picker series. The Time Picker is for those capturing time on a daily basis, e.g. clocking in of employees or machine startup monitoring. It gives you the ability to capture time with speed. If you have captured time before, I'm sure you will agree with me that this is the most annoying thing to do. Why? Because for a perfect analysis, time is not time without a date. For example, in this dummy timesheet, some employees work overnight. So, these employees clock in today and clock out tomorrow. As you can see, a date is a must. So, to manually capture time in this worksheet, you must write all these characters one by one. And that's a waste of time and energy. Thanks to this time picker, you can now achieve this in just a few clicks and with fun. As I said, this example file will be available for downloads. Use it to test drive the date and time picker. Now, if you want to exit the time picker without changing anything, you can do so via the footer or the close button. That is, if you are on the modal view mode. However, if you are working on the worksheet, if you click on a different cell, the date picker will know your intentions and exit the date picker for you.